Velodyne Lidar sensors have to be really tough. They have to be able to survive in extreme weather temperatures and all kinds of terrain. They have to keep us safe. That means they simply cannot fail. That's where I come in. My name is Kyle Pelton. I oversee Velodyne's reliability testing. In order for Velodyne to ensure that the sensors or products that we build are gonna survive years of function out in the world, we do our own reliability testing in-house. We have an engineering group that oversees all of the design engineering reliability specs, but once they are rubber stamping it saying it meets the design spec, I get a hold of it and I beat the heck out of it and make sure that our customers are gonna be happy. Now, yes, we do have a little bit of fun where I do put a Velodyne on a robot dog and make it walk up and down the stairs 20 times. But most of our reliability testing is very calculated. We have humidity chambers, thermal shock chambers, Haas chambers, vibration tables. We beat the sensors up the best we can in a controlled manner. Therefore, we can collect the data from them. This is one of our thermal test chambers. This chamber is currently running down to negative 65. We're gonna get a sensor inside here and show you guys what we can do with it. I would not wanna be inside of here myself. The main principle of thermal testing is to ensure that the electronic devices inside can handle very rapidly accelerating or decelerating temperature coefficients. We don't want the sensor failing when it receives a snow block or vice versa, a sun in the Sahara. So this is Velodyne's noisy end of the building. This is where our vibration testing is done. We do our own in-house Z-axis and Y or X-axis, depending on how we have the system flipped, to do all of our vibration testing. So behind me, we're running one of our H800s through a cycle that's actually built for one of our customers.
So if you think of an automotive application, you have to simulate what the industry would consider a normal daily drive, which can consist of high frequency vibrations, low frequency impacts. A lot of questions came up with our customers of what happens when I run over a pothole. Is the image steady? And yes, absolutely. We actually have systems that are designed to counter those. We need to ensure that all of the optics are in place and stay in place. We learn, we iterate, we redesign, and we test again, and we test, and we test, and we test. Once we've done our job, we share that data with the engineers so they can make recommendations to improve the design so that the sensor is ready to face anything the world can throw at it.